Hello dear students, today we will take up part 3 of lesson number 11, the case of copied question papers. In this part, we will discuss the extracts and question answers of this lesson. First of all, we will take up the question answers. First, why was Soames upset? Mr. Soames was upset because someone had tampered with the proofs of scholarship question papers in his absence. Second, how did Soames conclude that the papers had been tampered with by someone? Mr. Soames left the 3 long slips of proofs of question papers together on his table. On his return, he found that one of them was on the floor, one was on the side table near the window, and the third was on the table itself. Question number 3. Why did Holmes ask for a pencil from all the 3 students? Holmes asked for a pencil from all the 3 students as he found some pencil sheets in Mr. Soames' room. How did Bannister help Gilchrist? Why did he do so? When Mr. Soames came back, Gilchrist took his shoes and hid himself in the room, but he forgot his gloves on the chair. Bannister pretended to faint and sat down in the same chair to hide Gilchrist's gloves. Bannister was a butler at Gilchrist's house before working for Mr. Soames. He did all this to give Gilchrist a chance to escape. Next, why did Gilchrist decide to skip the examination? Gilchrist decided to skip the examination as Bannister spoke to him as a father. Bannister set him on the right path by making him understand that what he did was wrong. Next, Holmes' question. Why couldn't Soames solve the mystery behind the copied question papers while Holmes could do it in a short time? Mr. Holmes couldn't solve the mystery behind the copied question papers while Mr. Holmes could do it in a short time because he had a nervous and excitable temperament. He was careless too, as he went out leaving behind the valuable question papers. While Mr. Holmes was an efficient detective, he was vigilant and a keen observer also. Next, values based. Was it right to set Gilchrist free at the end? Should he have been punished or not? Yes, it was right to set Gilchrist free at the end, as he had accepted his mistake and realized that what he did was wrong. He should not have been punished as he had repented and decided to skip the examination. Extract. First extract. We have a very painful incident at the college. Identify the speaker. Whom is he talking to? The speaker is Mr. Soames. He is speaking to Mr. Soames. What is the painful incident? The painful incident is that someone has reached to the proofs of scholarship question papers. What does the speaker want from the listener? The speaker wants the listener to help in finding out the culprit. Second extract. I think he wrote very fast and broke his pencil and had to sharpen it again. Whom does he refer to in the above line? He refers to Gilchrist. On what basis does the speaker draw the above conclusion? The speaker draws the above conclusion on the basis of the pencil sheets. How does this conclusion lead to the solution of the mystery? By looking at the pencil sheets, Mr. Holmes found that the pencil was not of an ordinary size. Its outer color was dark blue and had a soft lead. He found the same pencil in the crisp room. Next, third extract. Why did you commit such an action? Who is the speaker? Whom is he speaking to? Mr. Holmes is the speaker. He is speaking to Gilchrist. Second, what action has the listener committed and why? The listener has copied the question papers for scholarship because he wanted to get the scholarship. Third, how does he mend his action? To mend his action, he decides to skip the examination. Next, name the play and its writer. The play is The Case of Copied Question Papers and the writer is Arthur Conan Doyle. So, Your homework, you will learn and write all the extracts and question answers of lesson 11. I repeat, you will learn and write extracts and the question answers of lesson number 11. Goodbye. Take care of yourself.